lo bebe mi baba nigba ti oro fe dojuru agoju loluwa o ile aye ko ma ni jogun ofosa iwa lo le meru ko daba ko so boro kini doloro Shogi arami Koma ni baso nufara ye mu Nitori Asade be, asade be You give me answer repete Asade sing, asade sing Your blessing does a shower, shower
Take a word.
My name is Wookie Gbenro. I'm a messenger of the Word of God. And I have a message from the Lord God, the creator of heaven and earth, for you today. The Bible in Psalms 121 and verse 1, the Bible says, I will lift up my eyes to the hills, from whence comes my help. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. In verse 6, it says, the sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. Verse 7, the Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth, even forevermore. Today, I'll be sharing what I call help from above. Everybody on earth needs help. Every man on earth, whoever the man may be, every man on earth needs help, but not from everybody. I'm going to say that again. Every man on earth needs help, but not from everybody. It's not everyone that can help you. The truth of the matter is that there is no man on earth who doesn't need help, but not from everybody. God has never created a man who can succeed in isolation. The way God has wired us, we succeed in networking. There is no general without an army. The only general in the Bible without an army, Samson, died ahead of his time. Even the Son of God, Jesus Christ, said, I'm not alone, in John chapter 8 and verse 16. In John chapter 16 and verse 32, Jesus said, if all of you should desert me, the Father is still with me. There is no one, it's only a fool that will say, I don't need help. Anytime you hear a man saying, I don't need help, run away from that man. One of the reasons why we all need help is because, number one, God wants us to know, God wants you to know that not only do you need Him, you equally need people to succeed in life. Number two, you can't run the race of destiny alone. Number three, God wants us to know that whenever He answers our prayer is to glorify His name. The next question you need to ask is, why do I need help? You will need help, number one, when you have an assignment that your natural capacity cannot handle. And I know there are many people out there, you have an assignment that your natural capacity cannot handle. And once your natural capacity can't handle certain assignment in life, then you need help. Number two, you will need help when you are faced with challenges that your natural capacity can't cope with. And there are quite a lot of people that are going through a lot of challenges that their natural capacity cannot cope with. Number three, you will need help when your circumstance becomes insufficient for what you need. When your circumstance become insufficient for what you need. Imagine a situation where you have a project of, let's say, 2 million naira, and you don't even have 20,000 naira in your account. Then you will need help. You will need help. Nations, states, society, organizations always come to a point when they have situations that a natural capacity cannot handle, and therefore they will need help. There are people in the Bible who also at one time or the other who were anointed, who still needed help. One of such men was Moses. Moses was heavily anointed of the Lord. Moses was a man of God. Moses was a man who had the privilege to speak on one-on-one with God. We all know the story of Moses, the man who raised his rod and the Red Sea parted. The man who dropped his rod in Pharaoh's palace and his rod turned to snake. And then the magicians did the same thing. And when they did the same thing, his own snake swallowed their snake. Moses was heavily anointed of God. But then there was one day that the nation of Israel was fighting the nation of the Amalekites. And then Moses sent Joshua to go and fight. And he stood on the hill and then he raised the rod. And for as long as the hands of Moses was up, Israel would be winning. But it got to a point that the Bible says that the hands of Moses became weary. Even Moses, with all the anointing, got to a point when his hand became weary. You may need to get to a level when you become weary. You can become weary financially, spiritually. When you get to that level, you will always need help. At that moment, the Bible says that Aaron and Hur came. They gave Moses a stool to sit, and then they held his hands. My prayer for you is that in the day when your hands will become weary, may the Lord send your Aaron, your Hur, who will raise your hands until you win the battle. David also in the Bible. David, for Moses' story, it was in Exodus chapter 17 from verse 9 to 16. Exodus 17 verse 9 to 16. And of course, for David, we know David to be a wonderful general, a powerful general. But I was wondering in 2 Samuel in chapter 23 from verses 15 to 17, that David was thirsty and the only source of water was located in the camp of the enemies, the Philistines. The Bible says that David just thought aloud. He was a general. He could give an instruction. Can one of you get me water? But he didn't give an instruction. He only thought aloud. I wish I have water to drink. And three young guys overheard the yearning, the desire of David. They took their life on the line. They went to the camp of the Philistines and they got water for David. And when David saw it, he said, wow. Now, in the day when you'll be thirsty, may the Lord send your way faithful men that are loyal, that are ready to listen to your groanings and to run on your behalf. Also, in the Bible refers to Jesus Christ in Luke chapter 8 and verse 3. And the Bible mentions about certain women that minister to Jesus out of their substance. Jesus was the Son of God. He was heavily anointed. He was sent by God to this world. But even when he was here to fulfill his earthly ministry, God brought certain women who ministered to Jesus out of their substance. Elijah, after he shut heaven in 1 Kings chapter 17 and from verse 1 downward, and then there was no food, God sent the raven to go and feed Elijah. If you know Bible story very well, you will know that raven was an unwilling messenger, but even an unwilling messenger favored Elijah. I've been told about Reinhard Bonnke, who had a woman in his ministry by the name Suzette, who will always come and intercede for Reinhard Bonnke in his life. I come to a conclusion that every man, including you, needs help. And I pray today that help will come your way and help will never, never be late for you. Because for some people, help may come their way, but help may be late. For some people, they will tell them, oh, if only you had come 5 minutes ago. If only you've been here 30 minutes ago. If only you've been here. Now, help may eventually come or it may be late. But my prayer for you is that help will never be late for you. For Psalm 46 and verse 1, the Bible says, it's a very present help. Whenever you need help, wherever it may be, at that particular time, may the Lord show up for you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Also in Revelation chapter 12 and verse 16, the Bible says, and the head helped the woman. May all that God has created come your way to help you, to assist you in the name of the Lord Jesus. You begin to find out, what shall I do when I need help? Number one, recognize that you need help. Number two, recognize your limitations as a human being. And number three, be humble enough to ask for help. Number four, never expect from man what only God can do. Never expect from man what only God can do. And number five, do all you can and let God do what you can't. I'm going to say that again. Do all you can and let God do all that you cannot. I pray for you today. I'm sent by the Lord and I pray for you today, that wherever your capacity will fail you, wherever your strength will fail you, may the Lord show up for you in the name of the Lord Jesus. This moment I decree, may help come for you from above in the precious name of the Lord Jesus. May God of heaven supply grace for you in the name of the Lord Jesus. I bless you. Whoever is watching right now, wherever you need help, may help come your way in the name of the Lord Jesus. Receive divine lifting, divine help. Areas where you have failed, you've tried, you've done everything, and your capacity could no longer take you further. May God supply strength and help in the name of the Lord Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. Help is coming your way. I believe my name is Buki Gbero again. I'm the shepherd of the Vineyard Assembly, incorporated in the city of Ibadan, located around House 19, number 1 Bashoro Estate, around General Gas and Akobo. Wherever you're in the city of Ibadan, we'll be glad to have you worship with us and receive the word of God. From this day and forevermore, you will never lack divine help. God will help you in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you.
You are lifted, oh Jesus.